is a 2014 Rolls-Royce Ghost. And it's not a phantom. This is the Rolls-Royce you get if you can't afford the real thing, or so people say. The truth is that the Ghost is an unbelievably luxurious, impressive, opulent, wafting machine, and used models like this one are becoming more affordable. Today, I'm going to review this Ghost and tell you why it's worth considering. Before I get started, be sure to check out Cars and Bids, which is my enthusiast car auction website for cool cars from the modern era, now with free listings. You can list your cool cars for free and auction them on Cars and Bids. And we've had some great sales recently, including this F10 BMW M5, which sold for over $38,000 in a great color with a 6-speed manual, this Saab 9-4X SUV, which brought just under $10,000. We love the quirky stuff. And this Lexus LX450 with low mileage, which brought almost $50,000 as enthusiasts are flocking to the 80 series Land Cruiser. If you're interested in buying or selling a cool car from the modern era, the 1980s and up, Cars and Bids is the place to do it, with daily auctions and great selection at carsandbids.com. So let's talk Ghost. This car came out back in 2010, and right away it developed a reputation as being kind of a lesser Rolls-Royce compared to the flagship Phantom. This car also rode on the same platform as the BMW 7 Series, so the thinking was, oh, it can't be a true Rolls-Royce, not a real Rolls-Royce model. I never saw it that way. Yes, the Ghost shared its platform with the 7 Series, but the Rolls was built in England at the same factory where they built the Phantom, not the BMW. And yes, the Rolls used the BMW V12, but that was the very top engine in the 7 Series that was a stretch for most 7 Series buyers, and it was modified to meet Rolls-Royce standards. And then there's the styling, the luxury feel. This was a very different car from the BMW 7 Series. But it's starting to be priced like a BMW. Early Rolls-Royce Ghost models are now easy to find for under $100,000. This car, being a 2014 model with lower mileage, is going to be more expensive than that, but it's still available for a fraction of its original price. And today, I'm going to show you what you get for the money. First, I'll take you on a tour of the Ghost and show you all of its interesting quirks and features. Then I'll get it out on the road and drive it, and then I'll give the Ghost a DOUGSCORE. All right, I'm gonna start the quirks and features of this Ghost by climbing inside, and that means starting with the key, which isn't really all that unusual, just looks like a fairly regular key, maybe a bit more luxurious, but it does do something cool. Press this button to unlock the doors, and they unlock, but also the Spirit of Ecstasy hood ornament appears from the front of the car, and then proudly stands in place, letting you know that this is a Rolls-Royce. It's hidden until you unlock the doors. You press this button, the actual Spirit of Ecstasy button on the key fob that locks the doors, and then the Spirit of Ecstasy itself goes back down into the grille so that it's hidden when your car is parked and locked, and then no one will come along to steal it. Not just a hood ornament, but a movable hood ornament that's up or down depending on whether the car is locked or unlocked. But anyway, next you climb inside the Ghost and you discover this car's party trick. That would be some unbelievable trim with incredible attention to detail that's part of a $58,000 option package. Yes, this car has a $58,000 option package with some unbelievable detail work. Let's start on the door panel. You can see this little compass logo, wood inlaid into the wood, and also you have this silver trim running the edge of the door panel. Looks very beautiful. Move into the center console, and this little panel also has this beautiful compass logo on it on the dashboard. Again, very, very beautiful. Move over to the passenger side of the dashboard, though, and this incredible piece of wood trim really stands out in this car. This is probably the most striking part of this $58,000 trim package, showing all these wood pieces like an explosion almost on the the dashboard, and you have the compass in the very bottom right where all the wood is basically exploding from. And again, you have this silver trim on the dashboard separating the wood from the lower part of the dashboard. Tremendously beautiful pieces. Another wonderful part of this trim package is in the center console. You can see right here all of these stars stitched into the side of the center console next to the seats. Your normal car doesn't have that, but this one does when you pay $58,000 extra for stuff like this. You also have coordinates in this car, all throughout it, in fact. On the door sill, you can see it says Rolls-Royce, handcrafted in Goodwood, and it gives a set of coordinates. Those are the coordinates for Goodwood in England, where this car is built. And you also have similar coordinates on the interior clock. You can see right here on the clock face itself, in very tiny font, you have the coordinates to Goodwood once again. Again, part of this luxury detail package that sets this apart from other regular Ghost models. You also have the coordinates up front on the Spirit of Ecstasy hood ornament. You can see the coordinates are printed around the base of the Spirit of Ecstasy, once again showing the coordinates for Goodwood. Another little piece of attention to detail. You wouldn't notice that one unless you look real close, but it's there. It's also in back. You open the rear door, and on the door sill there, you once again have Rolls-Royce, manufactured in Goodwood, with the coordinates written out. Again, little pieces of attention to detail that contribute to this car's especially luxurious interior. Now, when you're in the back, you can see more beautiful trim, like the wood that you saw up front. On the backs of the front seats, you have this similar striking design like you have in the front dashboard, but now it's carried into the back in both rear seats. This very, very beautiful wood design helping this Ghost stand out from all of the regular, normally optioned Ghost models. And the embroidered stars make an appearance back here as well. In the rear seat back in the center, you can see there they are, again looking very luxurious and special to distinguish this car from regular Ghosts. And indeed, this car is a lot more luxurious than regular Ghost models. This is the window sticker. The base price of a Ghost back in 2014 was $263,000, but this car has a total sticker price of just under $400,000, meaning it has almost $140,000 in optional extras. That is incredible. The vast majority of cars cost less than just the options in this car. But that's not all that surprising, considering one option package costs $58,000. And indeed, a lot of stuff in this car is really, really expensive. For instance, front and rear heated and cooled seats, nice feature to have. Well, in this car, they're almost $4,000 extra. This panoramic sunroof, which like family crossovers have, in this car, it was around $7,500 extra as an option. Rolls-Royce makes you pay extra for everything, and they don't just make you pay a little extra, they make you pay a lot extra. And that's how you get to a sticker price of almost $400,000. But that wasn't the only expensive option on this car. In fact, a lot of the options are expensive, really expensive. For instance, you want a camera system in this car. In a lot of new cars, it's free or a small upcharge. In this car, it's almost $4,000 extra. The rear camera, probably standard by government mandate, but other cameras, almost $4,000 extra to get a few more angles. That's pretty crazy. But all the pricing for this car isn't exactly surprising, because it is tremendously luxurious in here. For instance, look around and you see pretty much zero plastic anywhere. And when you do see it, it's not like crappy little cheap looking plastic. It's high gloss, beautifully finished plastic, but mostly it's wood, aluminum, leather, stitching, all of the finest materials that you would expect. Some great examples of the high luxury in this car, the radio preset buttons. Either they look like glass or they are glass, but they're certainly not your usual cheap plastic, and they are very, very beautiful to check out. Another example of this car's crazy luxury, how about the switch for the power mirrors. In your car, it's a little plastic switch you move around. In this, it is a beautiful aluminum joystick. Very high quality, feels very heavy. Even though this isn't something you're going to use with any frequency, it still has to be the finest material available. And check this out, more luxury, the climate controls. In your car, you want to adjust the fan speed. There's a little graphic showing you like more or less fan speed, but that's not not elegant enough for Rolls-Royce. Instead, you have this little dial, and the different fan speed options are words actually printed out, and one of those words is soft. If you want softer air, or you can turn it up to medium, high, or max, but there's no, like, diagram that you have to figure out. Next up, another fantastic luxury touch in this car, the sun visor is beautiful leather, of course, but the very center of it is metal, so that you don't have to touch the leather and get your oily hands on it and damage it. Just this little piece where you'd actually put it down is metal to make it a little bit classier so it doesn't wear out. That's pretty cool. And another crazy luxury touch, the infotainment system controller, you can see here in the center, it is wrapped in leather. Even though every other infotainment system controller ever would just be plastic around the edges, this one is wrapped in leather so that when you're controlling the system, your hands don't have to feel plastic, they can feel high quality leather. And by the way, how do you like the fact that when you're moving this controller around, the center part doesn't move, so the Spirit of Ecstasy logo is always pointed up, just the little wheel around the Spirit of Ecstasy logo moves, the spirit stays in place. That is some nice attention to detail. And by the way, speaking of the infotainment system, in your car, you want to turn off your center screen, you just press a button and turn it off. In this car, you press this beautiful aluminum button, and then this wood panel comes down to cover the infotainment screen, so you don't have to look at just an ugly screen that's off. Instead, you have this beautiful wood panel with this gorgeous compass design. You want to turn the screen back on, press the beautiful aluminum button again, and then the panel rises back up, and then your screen is visible once again. And next up, speaking of the infotainment system, a couple of interesting quirks in here. One is the control for the Spirit of Ecstasy. You can go into the infotainment system, into the Spirit of Ecstasy section, and actually manually raise or lower your Spirit of Ecstasy hood ornament. You can see I press lower and it goes down into the car, or you can press raise and you can raise it up, or you can put it in automatic and it will raise or lower depending on whether the car is locked or unlocked, like I showed you before. But that is a pretty crazy quirk. You can choose whether you want your hood ornament to be flying in front of you, if you want to be showing off, or if you want to keep it down because you're worried it might get stolen because you're in a rough area. And here's another fantastic quirk of the center screen, the camera system. Press this little button here next to the parking brake on the dashboard, and it activates the camera system. And you can see when it's on, it's showing two separate camera angles sort of pointing to the left and to the right in front. Rolls-Royce does that because the front ends of their cars are so long, because it's such a big, luxurious car, that you might not be able to see around when you come up to intersections or junctions. So if you're having trouble seeing, you press the camera button and it will show you what is coming from the sides, and that allows you to have better visibility at an intersection. The cameras themselves are mounted here in this little orange reflector on the side of the car, so they're kind of hidden in place, but they do show you what's coming to the left or right, which helps mitigate the problem with having such a long hood. Visibility can be an issue. Well, not with this camera system. Kind of a cool quirk. Now, it's not all just amazing luxury features in here. There are also some oddities. For instance, the climate control temperature adjustment is done with these little wheels, not just a little dial that you put to the temperature that you want. Instead, you move the wheel around. You can see it goes from red to blue, and then that's the temperature that you'll be getting. Upper and lower wheels for upper and lower climate control. Very strange way to do climate control, but that's how Rolls has done it for years, and that's how they still do it. Also, an interesting quirk is the dials in the gauge cluster. You can see they're sort of set off from the regular gauge cluster, not like a traditional car's. They're not flat in there, there's no screen, but you have these sort of silver-rimmed, beautiful dials that stand out one by one. An interesting look. And by the way, speaking of the dials, another interesting quirk with the dials, in a Rolls-Royce, you don't get a tachometer showing your RPMs. Instead, you get a power reserve dial that shows you how much power you have left in reserve. So if you're going very slowly, it'll be sitting at 20, telling you you have 80% of power left. Or if you floor the accelerator, it'll go all the way to 100%, and then you have no power remaining in reserve. That's in place of a tachometer. Kind of an odd thing, but that's what Rolls's have. Next up, another interesting quirk in here is the CD player. There is an individual CD slot in here if you want to insert a CD, but there's also a CD changer, but it's hidden. You open up the glove box, You still don't see it, but if you push this little button, the CD changer automatically reveals itself so you can put in your CDs into the glove box. When you're done loading your CD, you just push it back into place, and then it goes back into its hiding spot inside the glove box. And finally, another nice quirk in here with the heated and cooled seats, you can see that you can turn on the heated and cooled seat at the exact same time. So your butt and back can be heated and cooled. Most luxury cars, heated and cooled seats, you can choose one or the other. But in a Rolls-Royce, you spend this kind of money, you can do whatever you want. And next up, we move into the back seat of the Ghost. Although even before you get in here, just opening up the door is a pretty neat trick. It opens backwards. It's rear hinged like this. You can see Rolls-Royce says this because it's easier for rear passengers to get in and out. Although I think they do it this way because it's a cool party trick in a very high-end luxury car and they just want to do something cool and exciting. But the other cool thing about this door is once you climb inside, you can press this little button, door, push that and the door will automatically close. That way you don't have to lower yourself to closing your own door. That would be something expected of a plebeian. Now, it's worth noting though that there's no umbrella in the Rolls-Royce Ghost door like there is in the door of the Phantom. The umbrella's in the Phantom's door so that your chauffeur can grab the umbrella and then put it over you before you climb outside. But the Ghost is the Rolls-Royce that you're meant to drive more than be driven in, so the umbrella is actually hidden in the driver's door of the Ghost. You can see it's right here. You pull it out and then you have your umbrella, and of course you can also just stick it back in, and there are little channels in the door that will drain the water in the umbrella so you don't have to bring it into your car where it will get wet. That is a nice luxury touch, a built-in umbrella in the door, and it's interesting to see they move it to the front door for the Ghost since this isn't the chauffeur car that the Phantom is. Although, with that said, it may not be quite as intended for chauffeur driving, but the backseat of the Ghost is pretty luxurious. I will start by that little door button next to the rear headrest where you have also a little mirror so that you can look at yourself back here, just like front passengers have in their sun visors. Next up, another fantastic luxury touch back here. I already mentioned this beautiful wood design on this wood panel on the back of the front seat, but what I didn't mention is that this wood panel is actually a picnic table. You can pull it out from the back of the front seat and then it can be used as a picnic table. You can set a drink on here or snacks or a meal or a laptop or whatever, and you have this little tray table while you're driving along. Both sides have that in back, pretty nice. But you can see behind the front seats you also have screens back here. Now these screens are not power operated in the sense that they don't tilt and fold out automatically like they do in some newer Rolls-Royce models, but you just lift them into the angle that you want and then your screen is pointing towards you. You press the power button and you can turn it on. Now the screen is controlled here. This is the center armrest and center console, basically the rear seats. When it's up and in place, it is a middle seat. And like I showed you, you have those embroidered stars on this piece, but you can also fold it down and you have controls for the rear screens. And you can see the rear screen has a lot of different options back here. You can adjust music, entertainment. You can go to the navigation system and enter an address and then have the car start navigating you there as the rear seat chauffeured passenger telling your driver where to go. You can do it all with these little controls here in the center console and this screen. You even have access back here to the owner's manual of the car. So you can go into the owner's manual and read about various different components of the car all while you're sitting in back and all on a screen rather than reading some traditional old school owner's manual booklet. Now you might be wondering, how exactly does this control know which screen it's currently controlling? Interesting one. You press this little button here, left controls the left screen, or press it to the right controls the right screen. So you can't be controlling both screens at once, but you can choose which screen you want to control with these little buttons. Pretty interesting. Now, also a nice luxury feature back here, the rear seats are power adjustable. Just like the front seats in your car, back seats in a Rolls-Royce are power operated. With these controls here on the side of this center console, you can move the seat around and adjust it to however you're most comfortable. And if you want to go back to sort of an upright position, you press this little button and it automatically takes you back to sort of an upright default seating position so that it's easiest to get out. Now over on the passenger side, not only can you adjust your seat, but you can also press this little button with a two on it and adjust the front passenger seat. That way, if you're sitting back here being chauffeured and you want more leg room, your chauffeur is driving on the driver's side, of course, so the passenger side is empty and you can move the seat forward and out of the way so you can have all the leg room that you want. So this rear passenger seat is really the choice seat in this car if you're being chauffeured around because you can get more space. Now, in addition to all of the rear seat power controls back here, you also have memory settings for the rear seats, which is not something you see in just about any car, but you pay almost 400 grand for a Rolls-Royce, rear seat memory is something that you get. But to me, the very best part about this whole rear seat luxury situation is what is behind this rear seat center console. You pull down on this little leather strap, this leather panel, and it reveals a refrigerator. You open that up, and that is where you can put your champagne to celebrate while you're in your Rolls-Royce. It also comes with champagne glasses. Pop open this little compartment and you can see two individual champagne glasses for rear passengers with the Rolls-Royce logo printed on the champagne glasses. Very classy and luxurious. And because you don't want champagne to spill anywhere, you can also put the champagne glasses in their own little cup holder. You pull out this cup holder from the front center console and you see it has like normal drink cup holders, but in this little refrigerator compartment, you have this panel. You can lift this out and then install it in the normal cup holder, and then you have champagne glass cup holders back here, and you can stick your champagne glasses in here so they won't fall over or get jarred around while you're driving. And that is pretty cool. An accessory cup holder designed specifically for your champagne glasses. That's a pretty nice luxury feature. Also, check this out when it comes to little panels popping out in the center here. This little silver button, you push that and it pops open to reveal an ashtray. Because of course this car has a rear ashtray for smoking cigars and drinking champagne, but that's not the coolest thing about this little pop-out component. If you push the button again, it pops out a little further, revealing a very hidden storage compartment. That is something you wouldn't know is there unless you really know it's there. It's a great way to conceal stuff in the back of this car. No one will ever find that that's there unless they've seen this video. Also worth noting, back here you have your own climate controls, two different climate zones back here, so each rear passenger can adjust the temperature using these weird temperature wheels to get to the desired temperature they want. And once again, you have a little fan speed dial back here that gives you various different options, including soft for your air temperature, if that's what you want. You also have heated and cooled rear seats, which is a very nice luxury touch, and once again, you can run them at the same time. So even if you're a rear passenger in this car, your butt can be getting heated and cooled at the very same time. While you sit back here and drink your champagne and smoke your cigar and adjust your rear screens using this center console. Wonderful luxury touches. And by the way, one last luxury touch back here is the floor mats. You don't get traditional carpeting in a Rolls-Royce. Instead, you get very fluffy lamb's wool floor mats back here. You run your fingers through it and you can see you have like very deep fluffy carpeting, and it just feels wonderful. The goal is you take off your shoes back here and you just put your feet on those carpets and relax in the back of your Rolls-Royce while you're being driven around. And next up, we move on to the trunk in the Ghost, which frankly isn't really all that interesting, although it is quite large, more than enough room for many GT3 RS watering cans. It's got a lot of space back here, and the entire trunk is completely and fully carpeted. All the sides, the bottom, even the inside of the trunk lid, which you almost never see, all carpeted like you would expect for a really high-end luxury car like this one. Now, underneath the trunk floor, you do have one cool thing, a few tools under here, including a Rolls-Royce branded wrench. You could get your own wrench, but it won't say Rolls-Royce on it. That is a cool little quirk. I also like the fact that the button to close the trunk doesn't have a picture of just any car with the trunk open. It is clearly a Rolls-Royce. Very clearly the design, they went to the trouble of making individualized Rolls-Royce buttons, which is just great little attention to detail. It's a cool touch. And next up, since I'm on the outside of the Ghost, let's talk over some of the interesting exterior quirks and features of this car. I want to start with styling, which is actually fairly understated for a Rolls-Royce. This car has a lot of the beautiful Rolls-Royce touches and features and luxury items, but styling definitely doesn't have quite as much presence as the Phantom. The Phantom is so clearly huge and bulbous and obscene wealth, and it just projects so much. The Ghost definitely fits in a little bit more. It doesn't quite have as much of a look at me in your face image. Some people probably like that about the Ghost, and some people spending this kind of money would probably want a little bit more craziness with their luxury car design. But the Ghost certainly a little bit more understated in the world of Rolls-Royce. But anyway, cool exterior quirks. One is the fact that the doors close automatically from the outside as well. If you tap on the door when it's open and just sort of start pushing it closed, it will automatically do the rest for you. You can let go and it will completely close itself and latch, so you don't have to like slam the door or even get it close to closing. It'll do it all for you. A very nice luxury feature, as you would expect. I also love these wheels. They look very opulent. They don't have like spokes like a sports car has. Instead, there's this big silver plate in the middle with like little spokes on the outside. Very luxurious, very wealth projecting. Also worth noting, the Ghost, just like the Phantom, has weights in the center of the wheel so that even if you're moving, the RR logo is always facing up. So it doesn't matter how you park the car or where or whether you're driving, RR is always facing up thanks to this little weight in the center of the wheel, which is again a very nice piece of attention to detail in the luxury car world. And next up, one other exterior item I forgot to mention. On the side of the car, you have this pinstripe that goes the entire length of the car. This is supposedly hand-painted, and in the front fender, you can see it's like two levels, and the lower one finishes at one of these compass designs, like you saw inside, part of that $58,000 package. And like I said, hand-painted, supposedly it takes several hours per side of the car to paint on this glorious pinstripe, like you'd expect from a Rolls-Royce. And finally, we move under the hood of the Ghost, where you can see the Rolls-Royce V12. Except it isn't actually a Rolls-Royce engine. It's heavily based on the V12 from BMW that's in the 7 Series. But keep in mind, when people say, oh, the Rolls-Royce Ghost is really just a 7 Series, keep in mind that first off, the Ghost's base engine is the 7 Series top engine, and not that many people get a V12 in the 7 Series, but it's standard here in the Ghost. So even if these engines were identical, the Ghost and the 7 Series are already pretty distinctive since the Ghost has the top engine. But these engines are not identical. The Rolls-Royce engine is a little bit different from the one in the BMW. There are a few changes made, and the result is more power. The Rolls-Royce makes about 565 horsepower, whereas the 760 from this era, the BMW, had about 535 horsepower. So this car has a little more power, and of course it says Rolls-Royce all over the engine on both sides, and you even have RR on the oil cap. Just to remind everybody that this is a Rolls-Royce. No, seriously, it's not a BMW. Just look at the engine. It says Rolls-Royce all over. And so, those are the quirks and features of the 2014 Rolls-Royce Ghost. Now it's time to get it out on the road and see how it drives. All right, driving the Ghost. I have never driven a Ghost for a review. I did a review on the brand new Ghost that just came out. But it was still like a pre-production car and I wasn't able to drive it. So this is the very first Ghost I've ever reviewed, which is kind of funny because these have become pretty ubiquitous. And part of the reason for that is that they've gotten relatively affordable. I mean, like I mentioned, you can get an early Ghost for like 80 to 90,000. This one being a low mileage, high spec car, and it's a 14, not a 10, it's going to be a little bit more expensive than that, but we're still not talking about anywhere near the original sticker price. And so people are starting to see these come down in value and they're saying, yeah, that has some appeal. That's a pretty exciting and interesting car. So let's talk Ghost. Now, the thing that has always annoyed me about the Ghost is people say, my friends all say, oh, it's just a 7 Series with a different body. It couldn't be further from that. It's a completely different car. Yes, I understand that the powertrain and the platform are very similar, but it's built in Goodwood, and more importantly, it's just so much nicer in here. A 7 Series is a nice car, but the people who say that a Ghost is just a 7 Series are the kind of people who've never been in a Ghost. They don't really understand the differences that Rolls-Royce puts in its vehicles to make them more luxurious and feel more comfortable and this car has those differences. The steering is just like you're steering a cloud. Like, it's a very over-assisted, wafty feeling. I will grant you this car doesn't quite have the waftiness of the Phantom or the Cullinan, but it's still like on a completely different level from the 7 Series, which is kind of like it's a nice luxury car, but it's kind of sporty and just, you know, nice. This is like true ultra luxury. And it feels like that. And when you're sitting in this car, frankly, you don't have that much of a different vibe than you get in the Phantom. It is really, really luxurious in here. It feels very, very nice, very comfortable. You absolutely drown out everything that's happening out there in the world. You don't hear any cars going by. You don't hear people. You don't get disrupted. This is a luxury car environment, and it feels like a luxury car. I've really been impressed by the Ghost, in part because it's just, to me, it offers a lot of what the Phantom offers, but for way less money. So a new Phantom, well-equipped, is like $600. That's a lot of money. Even a used Phantom has remained very expensive. Like, to get a Phantom for $90, which is what cheap Ghosts go for, you gotta go back to like 04, 05 Phantom, and then you're getting kind of bad technology. Like, it's not all that nice. But Ghosts have depreciated to a point where you get a lot of the same Rolls-Royce experience, a lot of the same comfort and luxury, without really paying that kind of insane money like the Phantom costs. And so, yeah, you don't quite get the look of the Phantom or the feel, but everybody around you is still like, whoa, a Rolls-Royce. It still gives that kind of vibe. Not quite the same presence, but still a lot of the feel, a lot of the luxury for a lot less money. A 2014 Phantom, this is a 14 Ghost, a 14 Phantom is way, maybe twice the money that this car is. And I think this car offers a lot more than half of the experience. Now, I will say, in terms of the driving experience, worth noting, this isn't a sports car. You know, Bentley was always historically the car to drive. Rolls-Royce was the car to be driven in. And that has, even though they're now owned by different brands, that has remained kind of true. Rolls-Royces definitely do feel more luxurious, more wafty, more comforting. And don't mistake this for a flying spur. That car has a lot more athletics. This definitely does not feel like that. Even when you're going all out, even when you're pushing through corners, it is not the intent of this car. It will not reward you. That is not what this car is about. With that said, that's not to say I don't like it. I do like this car. I like it a lot. It's just a different vibe. It's a different feel. It gives you a different experience. This is intended to be the luxury car rather than any form of sporty or performance car. And honestly, at that it succeeds, and it especially succeeds well given the price point. I think that this is an impressive, nice, comfortable luxury cruiser. And especially as they're getting cheaper, it's just like, oh, it's so nice in here. And you have the Rolls-Royce feel, and this is just it's a different level from cars like the S-Class and the 7 Series that you don't quite understand until you're sitting in here laughing at all of the plebeians around driving normal cars. And so that's the Rolls-Royce Ghost. This is a superb luxury vehicle, very far removed from the BMW 7 Series, a fantastic luxury car all on its own. I love how these look, I love the equipment, and I love how they drive. And you're cruising around in one of these, and everyone who sees you will think you are a connoisseur. Not that you can hear them or care about their opinions from inside the Ghost. Anyway, now it's time to give the Ghost a DOUGSCORE. And the DOUGSCORE is here, 61 out of 100, which places the Ghost here against some other used ultra-luxury sedans. Truthfully, the Ghost is a pretty impressive car, and it's becoming a pretty impressive bargain. It stands above the S-Class in terms of quality, presence, brand name, and the ultra-quiet interior and driving experience. The only question is long-term Rolls reliability, but if you're willing to roll the dice, this could be an exceptional car that shows up practically everything else on the road.